Video 3.2 Device Templates in Azure IoT Central. In this video, we will cover the following topics: device models, interfaces, properties, telemetry, commands, customizations, views. A device template in Microsoft Azure IoT Central is nothing but a blueprint that tells us about the characteristics and behavior of the device connected to our Azure IoT Central application. A device template includes device models, interfaces, properties, telemetry, commands, customizations, and views. We will discuss each section of the device template one by one in brief. Device models. A device model describes how a connected device interacts with Azure IoT Central application. A device template consists of one or more interfaces, and each interface can define a collection of device properties, commands, and telemetry types. A device model is defined in the form of a JSON file. The JSON file defines how the device should communicate with the Azure IoT Central application. The JSON file that describes the device model is written in Digital Twin Definition Language, abbreviated as DTDL. The Digital Twin's definition language comprises a set of meta-model classes used to describe the behavior of all devices and digital twins. The behavior of the device is described using 6 meta-model classes, including telemetry, command, property, interface, relationship, and component. Since data is the main component of any IoT solution, DTDL also provides a data description language compatible with JSON. Let us see an example device model JSON file for a temperature controller device. In this file, you can see 3 root components: telemetry with name working set, property with name serial number, and command with name reboot. This device model also includes 2 thermostat components and 1 device information component. Interfaces. A classic IoT device comprises custom parts and standard parts. Custom parts define the uniqueness of the IoT device, whereas standard parts are common to all IoT devices. These parts in IoT devices are called interfaces in a device model. Details of each part of a device are defined in interfaces. The device capabilities can be defined in DTDL. Related capabilities are grouped into interfaces. Interfaces define the telemetry, property, and commands of a device. Properties. Properties define the state of a device. For example, property can be used to define the on-off state of a coolant pump. Properties can also be some basic device property, like the device's firmware version. Properties are of 2 types: read-only and writable. Read-only properties are updated by device end only, whereas writable properties can also be updated at the cloud end. If the device is offline, then also the properties can be updated. It will start reflecting once the device is connected to the Azure IoT Central application. One more type of property apart from read-only and writable properties is cloud properties. Cloud properties are also a part of the device template, but are not part of the device model. Cloud properties are the device properties that are set on the cloud and remain in the cloud only. Cloud properties are never sent to the IoT device connected to the Azure IoT Central application. Telemetry. Telemetry fields define the measurements coming from the connected IoT devices. IoT devices consist of sensors. Whenever the sensor measures some value, it is sent to the cloud as telemetry data. Azure IoT Central uses the device model information, such as display names, display type, units, etc., to display telemetry values. Commands. Commands are sent from Azure IoT Central to the connected IoT device to perform specific tasks. For example, a command can be sent from the cloud to the device to reset the device. Commands execute within 30 seconds if the device is connected to the IoT Central. We can also queue the command if the device is offline by enabling the queue if offline option. Commands can have request and response parameters, as discussed in some of the previous lectures of this course. Customizations. Customizations are not part of the device model, but are part of the device template. As the name suggests, customizations let you override some of the definitions in the device model. For example, you can change the display name of the telemetry, etc. Customization may also affect the code written for the device model. Hence, do the customizations wisely. Views. Views are also part of the device template. Views help you monitor and manage connected IoT devices. A view can include charts to plot telemetry, tiles to display read-only properties, tiles to edit writable properties, tiles to edit cloud properties, tiles to call commands, tiles to display labels or images. That is all, folks. This brings us to the end of this video. Video summary. In this video, we have covered the following topics: device models, interfaces, properties, telemetry, commands, customizations, views. In the next video, we will explore Azure IoT Central on Azure portal.